Welcome back to my channel. Today we will going to discuss about one new open platform technology which is founded in August of 2014, which is named as Apache Flink. So in this video we will do some introduction about Apache Flink. So today's agenda is, first agenda is introduction to Apache Flink, and second we will discuss about Apache Flink ecosystem. This Apache Flink tutorial will help you in understanding about what is actually mean by Apache Flink. Basically, along with the Flink ecosystem, components and various Flink APIs, Apache Flink is an open source distributed data system processor which provides really fast, efficient, consistent and robust handling of massive stream of events that can handle both such as batch processing as well as stream processing. Okay, so Flink is like the first and only open source framework that has been demonstrated to deliver throughput of millions of events per second in moderate cluster as well as sub-second latency in millisecond, like exactly semantic for application step, and delivery with supported sources and sinks. And the next is like the result is really very accurate and support the event time. Okay, so let me show you that what is the actually official website is. That official website is https://flink.apache.org. So as you can able to see, this is the official website. Okay, and you can able to see that this is the Apache Flink is an open source platform for distributed stream and batch data processing. This is the Apache Flink ecosystem which we will discuss right now after a few minutes. And there are the several API such as data stream API, data set API and table API, which we will also discuss in this video. And as you can able to see that Apache Flink is like the properties is the first property is streaming fast. It's really very very fast because it is processing batch as well as the processing is really so fast into the millions of the data into the few seconds, as well as it is the streaming condition also, and supporting a good number of APIs, libraries and ecosystems. You can download even you can download Apache Flink right now. Apache Flink come with 1.1.4 version, and as I told you, this is a open source project, so you can also download from GitHub. Okay, and the rest thing we'll discuss in this video also. So let's jump toward the, as we can also you can see like that currently Apache Spark or Apache Flink is in more demand, so many people is thinking like Apache Flink is going to be replacing Apache Spark and something like that. So we will discuss both also I'm trying to create one video in which I will discuss what is the actual difference between Apache Spark and Apache Flink, and what is the methodology Apache Spark is following, and what are the methodology Apache Flink is approaching. So it is really very easy to understand which one is going further. Okay, so Apache Flink ecosystem, as you can able to see here, that Apache Flink ecosystems are divided into four main parts. The first one is storage, then next deploy, then third is kernel, and the fourth is API and libraries. Here, as you can able to see that I wrote here like dataset API and data stream API. So I'm going to discuss all this ecosystem one by one. Then you can easily understand and handle it very efficiently. Okay. So first of all, go and start with the storage component. So as we discussed before, Apache Flink is used for data process, means also for big data storage condition. Okay, so if I say as Flink is only a computation engine that does not have any storage engine, then we can understand. Let me show you once again. This is the my designed like Apache Flink ecosystem, and this is the website given. So as you can able to see here, that storage is not given, and I added a storage. It means we upon the storage we can implement Apache Flink so easily. Okay, so Apache Flink is designed to read and write data from different storage system as well as can consume data from streaming system. I'm going to below are the some storage streaming system from which Flink can read and write data. First one is the SDFS, as this is the very familiar for big data that help Hadoop data file system, and it is really Hadoop distributed file system is really very good for storing means large amount of data. Second, like LocalFS, HBase, MongoDB, RDBMS, S3, Kafka, there are the really very very good list for that. The second component is deployment. So deployment, and you can also say as a resource management. Okay, so this is the second layer in Flink ecosystem. Flink can deploy in the following mode, like either single JVM as a local, if you are going with the cluster, then a standalone cluster, or by using Yarn on Mesos, you can go with that particular cluster. And in the case of cloud, you means it will be implemented on either Google Cloud or either Amazon EC2 Cloud. So if you are not so much familiar with this term, like what is Yarn, what is Mesos, and what is Amazon EC2 2, and what is MongoDB and all the things, these are the like maximum are the open source, and these are the cloud name. I will try to create a few videos on that, the learning tutorial for each and every technology, by which it will be more easy and handy for that. So, but right now we are not going to discuss that. Means what is the exact meaning of Mesos, and what is that how we are going to implement on Google GCE or Amazon EC2, because right now this is just an introductory video about Apache Flink, not about the other technology. The third component of the Apache Flink ecosystem is kernel, and which is also called as the kernel of Apache Flink. Okay, this is supported for distributed streamline data flow. This layer provides distributed processing, fault tolerance, reliability, native interactive processing capability, and etc. And the last one is which we can say as the API and the libraries. Okay, so these are the following, which are the which deliver really capability for the Flink. First one is the dataset API. Okay, so in this API, it handles the data at the rest that is generated at various sources, like by reading text or CSV file, or from local collection, and allow user to implement transformation like mapping, filtering, joining, grouping, etc. Okay, so we can say the batch application is also executed in by using this streaming runtime. Some best practice for follow will working with dataset API is like use print command or collect command or name command. Print command is for fastly printing a dataset, or collect command is for fastly retrieval, as well as name command on an operator for eg searching in the log. So we will use this command into the later videos, and once we will see that what is the practical way to implementing Apache Flink and all the things. Okay, second way is like data stream API. So it handles transformation on continuous stream of data to process live data stream. It provide various operations like filtering, updating state, defining window, aggregation, etc. Some best practice for follow will working in data stream API are as really very follow, like to like if you are using print command, then it fastly print in the data stream, or if we are using env dot from element or env from dot from collection for getting data stream and start working on that. And the last one is that table API. In the table API, enable user to perform ad hoc analysis through language like SQL for relational stream and batch processing. And it can also embed it to in dataset and data stream API of Flink in both Java and Scala. Actually, it allows user to run SQL query on the top of Flink that saves them from writing complex code for data processing. So we can say that there are different table API which is present here, like operator are such as for select, filter, group, join, and all the things. Okay, so these are the basics of all Apache Flink ecosystem. I hope it is quite clear for you, and the meaning of each and every ecosystem is completely storage. It is deploying, after that kernel, and after that API and the libraries. Okay, in the last condition, what is the really best community for better learning? Because as I told, the Apache Flink is really new. In 2014 of August, it is established. So means it is really new. So the first community which I will suggest you that is like user mailing list. What we have to do, subscribe to the mailing list by sending an empty email to user, that is subscriber at splink.apache.org. Once subscription is confirmed, you will get a mail in your mailbox, and after that you can easily able to send whatever requirement mail on that user at the rate of splink.apache.org. Second thing is to follow on Stack Overflow. If you're getting any issue, just post a question in Stack Overflow and link them with a hashtag sign off link. And the third is IRC chat. In IRC chat, for joining the channel, you have to give hashtag link at irc.freedom.org, and you will join the channel and chat with the Flink community regarding this. So hope this is the basic of Apache Flink, and you understand that what is the actual meaning of Apache Flink, and from where you will get the better learning process and all the things. So in the next video, I will show you about how to installation of Apache Flink and how to work on that. So just tune with me. Don't forget to subscribe my channel, as well as please comment down if you are getting any issue in this video, and also please share with others. Thanks.